Yes, sir.
Many here who say they want to see me at this dead hour of the night. It's something is fishy. Only for people to come and discover that they are DSS men with trucks and all that. But the governor came and took me out of the hotel. They're trying to break into the rooms and all that.
So the door is still there. Just running the place.
When they saw the crowd,
it was the crowd that scared them. But the truth, I want to pass out. If anything, if I spend a day with the security operatives, if I spend one day with the security operatives, I have churches in 42 countries and I've alerted them. Every Nigerian embassy in those countries will be in trouble. If I spend one day with the security operatives, the damage that will happen in Nigeria will take 1 year to repair. If I spend one day in this country alone, I have over 500,000 people and their reactions already. If I spend one day, the damage that will happen in Nigeria will take 1 year to repair.
Told me that the security or the set of people that came to arrest him and the crowd out there, he is not safe in the hotel. And I felt it's right for me to go there because I was part of a crusade. If anything goes wrong, I will still be called to question. So the proper thing, whether he's a Christian or he's a Muslim, if I'm not aware of his being in town, it's a different ballgame. I was part of a crusade. And the distress call coming from a man that pulls such a crowd could lead into so many and so many issues and multiply effects on the state security. So the best thing is for me to go and get him from the hotel. I went there personally. I went to his room to pick his box and all that, and I traveled with him in my car to the government house. We cannot continue like this because the country currently is under siege, under police. It's like a police state.